everybody. We're going to continue our classes online. Therefore, I'm going to continue from 4.4, Oil Palm and its Importance to the National Development. So, dalam bahasa Melayu, yang ini dikenali sebagai kelapa sawit dan kepentingannya terhadap pembangunan negara. Alright, saya ada dua slide, tetapi saya akan menunjukkan slide bahasa Inggeris dahulu and continued by the English slide. Now, kalau kamu tengok di sini, the structure of oil palm fruit, there is many other labelings that will be given, but the main ones for exams is pulp, mesocarp, kernel, and shell, endocarp. So, if in bahasa Melayu, you can see there is bahagian sabut, mesocarpa, and then bahagian isirong, kernel, and bahagian tempurung, which is endocarpa. Now, the first two parts are the oil-producing parts, which is mesocarp, contains the largest amount of oil, while kernel contains the highest quality oil. Shell is actually the division between the minyak sawit or sabut from the minyak isirong sawit, which is the biji. So, this is the border that plans to separate the two kinds of oil. What is the difference here is if you realize this pulp mesocarp or mesocarpa actually produces, mesocarpa actually produces kandungan quantity yang banyak. That means high quantity but low quality. And then on isirong kernel, they have a very high quality oil tetapi kurang quantity, low quantity. And endocarpa or endocarp in English, shell does not consume any oil, I mean contain any oil. Now, if you move on to the next slide, if you take a look, this is the process of palm oil extraction. If you go on the highway, you can see on the left and right, there's a lot of palm oil, and Malaysia is a very large oil producing country, and we have the processing done in Malaysia itself. So if you see the process, it starts with sterilization, threshing, and digestion. Just take a look at Bahasa Melayu, Pensrilan, Penanggalan, dan Pencernaan. So what I can actually ask you to do is read through this, and there will be an exercise, and this exercise will help you to actually understand this whole flow better. Try to fill up whatever answers that you can. If you cannot, I understand, I truly get it. We will continue the revision when we start back our normal classes after the MCO. Alright, so but just to give you some understanding, what they're actually doing is when you collect the oil palm, bila you dapatkan buah kelapa sawit, apa yang kamu dapat ialah dalam keadaan besar dan dia ada dalam size setandan. That means if you can imagine like a larger size of a banana, but it's in a tandan format or whatever we call in English, we call it a bunch. So it's very easy. So what happens is when you sterilize it with hot steam and under high pressure, the fruits will start to disperse itself, will start to move away from the branch. So it's easier for you to remove it later on by using the thresher, the threshing machine, machine penanggal. And also when you use high amount of heat, you are able to kill the bacteria and fungi, which is very, very important. Now, selepas kedua-dua proses ini, penanggalan, pensrilan dan juga penanggalan, apa yang berlaku ialah mereka melakukan pencernaan untuk menghasil atau mengasingkan mesocarpa dan biji buah. That means they're planning to separate the mesocarp and the shell. Why? Because they have two different quality oil, so mixing it is going to waste the kernel oil. So the shell is actually going to produce the kernel oil while the pulp will go through, or mesocarp will go through a different process, which is extraction, filtration and purification. You can take a look at this whole process, read through and see what is happening. The notes in that will be provided will have all the answers there, and you can take a look and try to understand this. If you have any questions, please post it in the group so that I'll be able to answer you, or if we really can go through that, maybe we will try to organize an online class. Now, if you move on and you take a look at the next part, these are the uses of palm oil. Now, palm oil contains a very important constitution, mengandungi something we call as beta carotene. It is a very important oil where it actually helps to reduce the chances of somebody to get cancer. It's proven, but the amount of people using it is minimal. But Malaysians, we consider ourselves as good users of palm oil because almost all our food that we eat, or almost all the things that we use on a daily basis, contains it. So you can see the examples like cooking oil, minyak masak, ice cream, margarine, chocolate, printing ink, cosmetics. And then you can also see minyak pelincir, lubricating oil, biodiesel oil, which is the future because, yes, it also creates air pollution, but much, much more lesser. Lebih kurang berbanding pencemaran udara disebabkan oleh pembakaran petroleum yang kita belajar pada awal bab ini. So, you have to get the idea of how things work. So, please take a look at the examples, take a look at the whole idea of it. And last but not least, there's one more part here, which is quite important for you. There's this palm oil research by local institutions. The main four names that is already in our exams before is MPOB, MARDI, FELDA and FELCRA. So I don't believe that you have to study different kinds of facilities or institutions that do this. So you can see MPOB, MARDI, FELDA and FELCRA there. All their names are given to you in Bahasa Melayu and also in Bahasa Inggeris. So what we looking now is aktiviti penyelidikan dan pembangunan yang dijalankan. So kenapa mereka menjalankan penyelidikan? Why they do research? So the research is actually untuk mempertingkatkan quality and productivity, to improve the productivity and quality, and then mengoptimumkan penggunaan tanah. We cannot be wasting soil. Malaysia is not a very big country, so if we continue to expand our agriculture or our buildings, then we will have no forest, and that will damage the environment. So we have to manage in a way that we can actually plant palm oil, at the same time improve the environment. Then we also expand and improve the current oil, use of palm oil, find new uses of palm oil and spread news, especially on the benefits and uses of palm oil. Normally it's done to the foreign countries, like huge country like India or China, where their consumers are high. We can actually promote our products so that people can start buying, and this will improve the economy of our country as well as improving palm oil production. Right, so this is all for the lesson, but I believe that this won't be enough. So what I can do is I will wait for you to take a look at the slides, take a look at this recording and try some of the exercises. Then later on, we will have a discussion session where I will try to organize with our tuition centers, and I will be able to actually cater all your questions. And you can actually throw the questions back to me. You can actually personally message me if you want to. I'll try my best to reply as many as I can. As I have a lot of students at the moment, so please help me and try to ask me questions. I will also prepare an FAQ if it's possible. Now, if you take a look at this video before we end session, I hope you can take a look at what are the important things that we learn about.
Malaysia is a beautiful land that is vastly covered with forest. Amidst this is another precious green covering called oil palm trees, which today have helped millions to achieve economic independence while enabling those without a future to finally have a great one. This is the story of Malaysian palm oil, the journey from the fruits of the oil palm trees to being an essential at our kitchen table. It all starts here in a plantation. This is where oil palm trees are planted. They are perennial plants capable of growing up to 60 meters high, bearing fruits in bunches all year long. These fruits are called fresh fruit bunches or FFBs. Within each fruit are the palm kernel and the mesocarp. The palm kernel produces palm kernel oil, while the mesocarp gives palm oil. When these FFBs are harvested, they require urgent transportation to the mill. Using lorries or goods train, FFBs are transported within 24 hours to ensure that the highest quality of oil is produced. Once at the mill, a grading process takes place to identify the good ones and separate them from the unripe, rotten or overripe bunches. The selected FFBs then go through sterilization using a saturated steam gauge in large pressure vessels or cages. Here, almost all fruits are softened and detached from the bunch. They are then placed in a rotating drum to dislodge sterilized fruits through gaps between the bars, while the empty bunch is discharged from the other end. These soft fruits are turned into a homogeneous oil mash in a digester and screw press, from which crude palm oil is extracted and purified continuously through a vibrating screen, clarifier and purifier. Crude palm oil has an intense orange color due to the natural high levels of vitamin A and E. The oil has antioxidant properties and promotes high density lipoprotein or HDL, which is the good cholesterol in our body. But in this state, the crude palm oil is neither in edible form nor ready to be used, even in non-food products. It does need further processing before it can be used.
Alright, if you can see, this video is helpful to understand how the whole process works. The names might be different, but I can't change the names. I have to still use the names that are provided in the textbook. So that's the reason why I've used all the old names. But otherwise, you can actually watch this video and try to understand better. There's a part 2 video to this. You can actually check in YouTube. No problems. And if you have any other questions or doubt, please do ask me. Thank you for your time, and I hope you are staying safe during the MCO. Bye.